Atlantis, one of the four pillars of heaven. Just a quick one today. I've been researching various myths and legends from around the world that might tie into both Plato's Atlantis story and the Island of the Egg story inscribed into the Temple of Horus at Edfu. So really, this is more of a precursor to the next episode, but I have made some interesting discoveries. In the previous episode, I described the Azores hotspot and how its variable activity at times may cause the Azores Plateau to rise from the ocean, possibly every 3 to 5 million years according to one geological paper. It turns out that there are numerous cultures throughout history that speak of the first island rising out of the primeval water, pushed out by the fiery red tree of life. I'm going to propose that this tree of life might be the hotspot plume that sits below the Azores Plateau. In the pictures you can see how the plume might resemble a tree. The various stories throughout history also talk about the pillars that hold up the heavens. Some stories mention two pillars at opposite ends of the world. Others mention four pillars. I'm going to propose that these pillars are volcanoes that may have been sacred places in our past. I appreciate this might be rather vague right now, and I promise I will delve into this in much more detail in the next episode, but for now I will show you what I've found. Firstly, it's worth noting that the Earth has an approximate circumference of 40,008 kilometers. This is Google Earth, so it doesn't have as much bathymetric data as I've shown in previous videos. We can see a partial scan of what I'm proposing is Atlantis. This will be our starting point. I found evidence from both the creation stories and a gravity map tool that my friend Steve sent a link for that this might have been a volcano in the distant past. In various creation stories, the primeval island is called the navel of the Earth. I decided to link the Azores site with the largest volcanic crater on Easter Island, otherwise known as the navel of the sea. This is very close to another hotspot and is approximately 1/4 of the way around the world. If we continue to project this line and travel another 1/4 of the Earth's circumference, we arrive at the East Australia hotspot. Here I'm going to link to Mount Shank. The Aboriginal peoples of Australia have a creation story for this volcano. Let's continue with the projection to a site in India, again approximately another 1/4 circumference around the world. This is not a current hotspot, but here we find Mount Gurnar, a major igneous plutonic complex. This is one of the most ancient and important places of worship for both Jains and Hindus, with various temples populating the site. If we carry on with the projection for one final 1/4 of Earth's circumference, we complete the circle. As I said before, Earth's circumference is approximately 40,008 kilometers. This comes in at 40,013 kilometers. I don't fully close the circle as for some reason it causes Google Earth to behave strangely. I'm still a bit of a Google Earth noob. If we pan around the globe, we can see that although this isn't a perfect circle, it's pretty darn close. Could these be the four pillars of heaven? I'm wondering if there are dipoles from Earth's magnetic field that have influenced volcanic activity within these regions. It's interesting that this projection passes through Ecuador. A carved stone was supposedly recovered from a site in Ecuador in 1984 near a place called Guayaquil. This stone weighed approximately 350 kilograms, and it supposedly shows a map of an Ice Age Earth with the Azores Plateau above water. There are also projection lines on this map. I will show pictures after the Google Earth video is finished. There's probably no need to explain anything about Easter Island, otherwise known as Rapa Nui, as most people will already be very familiar with the impressive megalithic works. Mount Shank seems to stick out by itself in an otherwise level terrain. This volcano also seems to possess some unique geological features. I'm not sure how I've never heard of this particular site in India. What's interesting is that this very projection line seems to appear on the Ice Age stone map I will show at the end. Another interesting coincidence is that this projection line passes through Turkey. Göbekli Tepe sits a short distance south of the projection line. I'm not sure exactly where, it's around here somewhere. I believe the following two pictures of this Ice Age stone map are from somebody called Klaus Donner. I believe there are some videos of him on YouTube. If anyone could provide more information on this stone in the comments below, that would be great, because for all I know this could just be a hoax. There seems to be some natural sort of quartz veins on this thing that are looking a bit like projection lines, and you can see the natural vein here ends in Ecuador, approximately where the stone was supposedly found back in 1984. You can see what looks like South America, North America, Greenland, and in the middle, what almost certainly could be interpreted as the Azores Plateau. This is the other side of the stone. I appreciate it's not easy to see the outlines of the country, so I will highlight them in red. There's also what looks a bit like a projection line. This one's a hand-drawn one. I will highlight that yellow. And notice that this quartz or quartzite vein still runs around. And where the inlaid eye is, that looks to be about where Israel might be. Again, if anyone has more information on this, that'll be useful, because I don't know the legitimacy of this find. Like I said before, this is more of a precursor to the next episode, so hopefully you found it interesting, and hopefully it will make things clearer for episode 6 when it comes out.